I don't use a tablet normally, so I don't have any experience to tell people about the quality of such things. Maybe also because I just don't care about it. But now I have this brand new tablet and I'm going to test it. I don't play mobile games, I like fighting games, old games, and mainly I'm going to test emulators. Not real retro. Because obviously 8-bit and 16-bit console emulators work perfectly or almost perfectly. I'm not going to test everything like performance of different applications, no any specific tests. So it is Redmi Pad SE from Xiaomi. There are different versions of this model with different specifications. You can see all main info about the tablet from this video on the screen. All versions don't support SIM cards. It's solely a tablet with Wi-Fi. I didn't know, but it turns out that a lot of different emulators for Android prefer to work on Snapdragon processors. Most of PSP games work without any issues on slower devices, so everything is fine on this tablet. I tried to play using touch buttons on smartphones, it was really hard. I expected better experience on the tablet because of the size, but you know, I see no difference. Dreamcast games also can work on slow devices, but only if you use Redream emulator. Dead or Alive 2 works well. Even the snow stage. For some reason, all the Kino Fighters games need faster devices. Unfortunately, I forgot to turn on an FPS counter, but I can say that KOF feels a little bit slower only sometimes. In general, it works well. PS2 emulation goes not so well. It greatly depends on games. Virtua Fighter 4 runs at about 50 FPS. It's playable, it's just not perfect. Tekken 4 runs at 60. Sorry, I didn't shoot a gameplay. I thought I did, but no. I changed a button's layout to arcade stick type. It feels better, but anyway, I want to play on physical buttons. Saturn emulation is not completely terrible, it's just bad. Virtua Fighter 2 runs at normal FPS, but has a lot of artifacts. Dead or Alive runs at low FPS, very low sometimes. Both games are playable, but you can't enjoy it. I also tested Golden Axe, the duel. I didn't shoot a gameplay, It is 2D, maybe that's why it worked much better. I had only one Switch game image, it's Metroid Dread, 18 FPS, but it doesn't feel slow. The image quality is low, for me it's not a problem at all. I didn't play much, but I think it is completely playable. I don't know if it is possible to play in some quick combat moments. This game requires a delayed reaction. You should use a gamepad because using the touch buttons in this game is absolutely unacceptable. 3DS emulation is good, Dead or Alive Dimensions works well. The display size allows you to put screens and buttons in different places. I liked the default layout. Metroid Samus Returns works well too, but again it is impossible to play without a gamepad. I think the performance of this tablet for $178 is high enough. I didn't expect PS2 games to be playable. I immediately disabled receiving any system updates to prevent the tablet from becoming slower. Maybe the CPU is not the best, but 8GB of RAM provide this device with a good performance. I also connected a keyboard and a mouse to this tablet. They can work together, but if you change one of them to a gamepad, something will not work. Maybe it depends on each specific controller. Screen protector, $2. I was sticking it for the first time. It was hard to remove all the dust. I spent a lot of time doing that. I don't recommend buying 4GB RAM version. It can be cheaper, but only a little bit. I expect the performance to be much lower. In my city, the prices of different versions are almost the same. A tablet cover is more expensive than that difference. Flip cover, $9. By the way, it has 4 speakers and they sound really nice. Unfortunately, you can't hear the true quality, but it is really nice for a small device. The speakers are loud and don't crunch, don't choke, no matter what kind of music you listen to. And it also has 3.5mm audio output. It is very important nowadays. The battery discharges usually after 2 days of intensive gaming emulation. Of course, I don't mean I was playing all day and all night. And of course, it depends on the platform. But anyway, it is more than 12 hours. What else? Camera. I forgot about it and didn't test it. But I can say that it works in Citroen. Some games cannot be installed on my smartphone. I tried them on this tablet and they've been installed. I suppose it is because of Snapdragon processor. The King of Fighters 98 for Android works well. It has 4 different input options, including simplified for touchscreen. That's why Android versions are preferable to emulators if you have no any controller, especially if you are not at home. Another game that I couldn't install on my smartphone was Nikke. I think it works on this tablet, but I couldn't update it to launch. Later, I found out why. But it was a huge update and I just didn't want to download it.
足りないわ。